Namne, Shrimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namne, Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine, Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshantarine. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
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 Om Namo Bhagavate
Narayanam namaskrityam
Narayanam namaskrityam
Naram chaiva narottamam
Naram chaiva narottamam
Devim sarasatim vyasam
Devim sarasvatim vyasam
Tato jayamudirayat
Tato jayamudirayat
Nasta praeshu vabhadreshu
Nasta praeshu vabhadreshu
Nityam bhagavata sevaya
Nityam bhagavata sevaya
Bhagavati uttamashloke
Bhagavati uttamashloke
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtaki
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtaki.
So this week, I think 23rd, it's going to be the disappearance day of Om Vishnupad Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Thakur Srila Prabhupada.
Appearance day?
Is it appearance or I thought it was disappearance?
Disappearance. 本周12月23日, 应该是 Om Vishnupad Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Thakur Prabhupada 的隐居日.
So he is the spiritual master of our own founder Acharya Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada.
他是我们的创办人 Acharya Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada 的灵性导师.
And it was Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Prabhupada who established the Gaudiya Math.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Prabhupada 他确立了 Gaudiya Math.
In the times of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Prabhupada, the Gaudiya Math was united. There was only one Gaudiya Math. Today we see it all divided, many different branches. But in the times of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, there was one society called the Gaudiya Math.
在 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Prabhupada 的那个时代, 所有的 Gaudiya Math 都是统一的, 是一个, 但是现在我们可以看到, 所有的这些 Gaudiya Math 是有很多的分支, 有很多个。
So, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati was born in Jagannath Puri.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, 他是出生在 Jagannath Puri.
His father, his seminal father was Bhaktivinod Thakur, and at that time Bhaktivinod Thakur was the judge in Puri, and he was also in charge of the Jagannath Puri temple.
他的生理的父亲是 Bhaktivinod Thakur, 当时是 Bhaktivinod Thakur 是 Jagannath Puri 的法官, 并且掌管 Jagannath Puri 的神庙.
So Bhaktivinod Thakur had a large family. I think he had 11 children, and his desire was that these children would all help him to propagate Krishna consciousness.
Bhaktivinod Thakur, 他有一个庞大的家庭，我想他应该是有十一个孩子. 他的愿望是让这些孩子们帮助他传播 Krishna 知觉.
And from their childhood, they were trained in different languages, and they were trained also in reciting different verses from the scriptures, like especially Bhagavad Gita.
从他们的孩提时代起，他们便接受各种各样的训练。他们接受各种语言的训练，而且接受训练朗诵，像《Bhagavad Gita》这样的经典上的诗节。
So Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, he as a child he had memorized the whole Bhagavad Gita, and he also could understand it, and he could preach, he could explain the verses.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, 当他还是一个孩子的时候，便把整部的Srimad-Bhagavad-Gita记住了，就是背下来了。而且他不仅能够背下来，还能够解释。
from his birth, there were different signs that this child is very special, because when he came out from the womb of his mother, at that time the umbilical cord from the mother was wrapped around his neck like a Brahmin thread.
在他出生的时候，身上便显现了不同的吉祥的标记，因为在他生出来的时候，他母亲跟他连接的脐带便像一根布拉曼的圣线一样绕在他的脖子上。
If we saw that today, we'd be worried, oh, he may get strangled.
如果我们今天看到这种情况，可能会非常的担心，觉得他可能会被勒死。
But they took it as a omen that, oh, this child, maybe he's like a Brahmin.
但是当时大家把这个当作一个吉祥的征兆来对待，哦，这个孩子生下来他应该是具有布拉曼的品质。
And then when the child was a few months old, the Rathyatra festival took place, and when the mother brought the child out, she passed the child up onto the chariot to be placed at the feet of Lord Jagannath to get blessings. And at that time, one of the garlands fell off onto the child.
在这个孩子只有几个月的时候，他的母亲带着他出门，正好在举行 Rathyatra 弹车节。于是他的母亲就抱着他登上了弹车，把他放在主加格纳塔的莲花足下。这个时候，从神像的身上掉下来一串花环，正好落在这个孩子身上。This
was auspicious omen that this child is very special. He's got the blessings of Lord Jagannath.
这也是一个吉祥的征兆，证明这个孩子非常的特殊，他得到了加格纳塔的祝福。
And as a young child, one day his father brought mangoes home, and Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati's name actually, before taking the name Bhaktisiddhanta, his name was Bimal Prasad. And Bimal Prasad, he took the mango fruits without offering them. And so when Bhaktivinoda Thakur heard about this, then he told the boy, this is very bad. You've taken the fruit that was meant to be offered to the Lord. And you've taken it without offering.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, 他还小的时候，有一天，他的父亲回家带了一些芒果。当时在他叫 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 之前，他的名字叫 Bimla Prasad， 所以他就吃了一些这些芒果，没有供奉。等到 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 知道了之后，说：“哦，你做的这个非常的不好，因为这个芒果还没有给主供奉过。”
So when the child heard his father speak like this, he took it very seriously. And he vowed that he would never again eat mangoes. And throughout his life, he would not take fresh mangoes. If mangoes were offered to him, he would say, oh, I cannot take. I am an offender.
这个孩子非常认真地对待他父亲的话，所以他发誓一辈子不会吃新鲜的芒果了。每当有人给他供奉新鲜芒果的时候，他就说，哦，我不能吃，因为我是一个冒犯者。
So it gives us some idea of the determination which Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati had, which he kept throughout his life.
这样我们得到一些概念，就是 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 他有多么的有决心，他发了一个誓言，整个一生都追随他。
Even as a young man, you know, usually young men, they're very attracted to young women. But Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, as a young man, he established a society for brahmacharis.
即使当他还是一个年轻人的时候，一般年轻的小伙子会受到年轻的姑娘的吸引。但他年轻的时候，Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 他组建了一个协会，专门是给Brahmachari们准备的。And
he was preaching. He was getting young people to join him and to follow him, to listen to his words.
他在传播，他让那些年轻人们追随他，加入他，然后他们都听他的话。
If you go and preach about brahmachari life today in the colleges, people will laugh at you.
如果如今你们去大学里去宣传 brahmachari 的生活，人们会嘲笑你。
What's wrong with you? They will say, what's wrong with you?
他们会认为你有毛病吧。
You don't like women?
你不喜欢女人吗？
You know, so this is a the mood today, but Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, it was like that even in his times, but because he was a very renounced person, he understood the value of brahmachari, and he maintained that brahmachari position throughout his life.
就是如今的情况，但是 Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati 他那个时候也有这样的情况，但是他能够明白到真守生生活的价值，所以他发誓做 Brahmachari， 他一辈子都保持做一个 Brahmachari。
So he was a Naistika Brahmachari. He never allowed his semen to fall down. So because he was a staunch Brahmachari, he had a very strong memory and he was very determined and powerful in his preaching.
他是一位 Naistika Brahmachari， 他不会随意的浪费自己的精液，而且他在传播的时候非常的有力量。
People would run in fear. Mayavadis, if they heard that he's coming, they would run away in fear.
人们会在恐惧中逃走，尤其是 Mayavadi 们听说他要来了，就会害怕的逃走。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, as a young man, he was very expert in astrology, and he wrote a.commentary on the Surya Siddhanta, and after writing that book, he was offered a seat as a professor in the seat of Calcutta University.
年轻的时候 ，Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 他非常的擅长占星，他撰写了一部关于 Surya Siddhanta 的评论。因为这部评论的缘故呢，他被加尔各答的大学授予为教授。
But he said, "No, that I'm not interested in that. That life is not for me."I want to take up spiritual life.
但是他说，我对于这种生活不感兴趣，这种生活不是给我准备的，我对于灵性生活更有兴趣。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he first met our Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada in 1922.
在1922年的时候 ，Srila Bhaktisiddhanta 遇到了我们的 Bhaktivedanta.
So.In another few weeks, we'll also be into 2022, so we'll be exactly 100 years since the first meeting between Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati and our Bhaktivedanta Swami.
再过几周之后就会变成2022年，那么这就将是Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 和我们的 Bhaktivedanta Swami 第一次会面100周年。
And by the grace of Lord Krishna.The devotees have acquired that property, which is in a place in Calcutta called Ultadanga, and they have a nice temple there.
通过 Guru 和 Krishna 的仁慈，我们的奉献者在加尔各答得到了这一个，就是他们第一次见面的地方，叫做 Ultadanga.
So they'll be having a very big celebration there in the new year.
在新年的时候，那里会举行一个很盛大的庆祝。
Celebrating the 100th anniversary of the first meeting.Between Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati and Bhaktivedanta Swami.
会庆祝 Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 和 Bhaktivedanta Swami 的第一次会面。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he first of all came to live here in Mayapur. He came alone and he took a vow to chant the holy name many, many thousands, many lakhs of times.
去了 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati， 他独自一人来到了 Mayapur， 他发誓要唱诵很多很多 lakh 那么多遍的圣名。
How many crores did he chant? How many crores of names? How many lakhs rather chanted? I think it was 10 million names. 10 million names.、Mm-hmm.
应该是10亿遍圣名。
Anyway, it took him several years to chant.
他花了好几年的时间才唱诵。
And there was nothing here in Mayapur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur had established a small temple at the Yoga Peak.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur, 他在 Yoga Peak 建立了一座小庙。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was staying there, taking care of the place.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 就坐在那里照顾这个地方。
And there was not even much covering. Sometimes he would just sit under an umbrella and chant.
那个地方没有什么可遮风避雨的，有的时候他就打一把伞，坐在伞下唱诵。
But it happened, it so happened, one man came and met Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati and understood that he was a very great soul, a very self-realized soul, and he arranged programs for him in Calcutta.
然后来了一个人，这个人认识到是了 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 是一位伟大的灵魂，一位觉悟了自我的灵魂。所以想为他在加尔各答安排节目。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he had to first of all take sannyas. He had to officially renounce the material world. He had to change his cloth into, he wanted to put on the dress of a renunciate.
但是Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, 他必须要改变自己的身份，他要做，他要接受sannyas，他要改变自己的服饰。
He had already taken his initiation under the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he'd taken from Gorkishore Das Babaji.
在Bhaktivinoda Thakur 的教导之下，他已经从 Gorkishore Das Babaji 那里接受了启迪。
Gorkishore Das Babaji was an illiterate person.
Gorkishore Das Babaji 是一个文盲。
But Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was a great scholar, proficient in many languages.
但是 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 是一位学者，而且擅长多种语言。
But Bhaktivinoda Thakur told him that this man, Gorkishore Das Babaji,He's very renounced. He's a very good person. You should take initiation from him.
但是 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 告诉他的儿子说，这个人非常的气绝，你应该从他那里接受启迪。
But Gorkishore Das Babaji said, "No, I don't want any disciples."
但是 Gorkishore Das Babaji 说，不，我不想接受任何的门徒。
I have enough headaches.
我已经有足够的头疼了。
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati came back and told Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, no, you have to convince him to accept you. If you don't get initiation, your life is useless.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 回来，然后呢 ，Bhaktivinoda Thakur 就告诉他说，你必须要说服他，让他接受你，给你启迪，要不然的话，你的生命是没有用处的。
Initiation is very important. It's essential.
启迪是非常重要的，是核心。
And so Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati came back again and pleaded, give me initiation. So Gorkishore Das Babaji said, well, I'll ask Krishna. Let me ask Krishna, see what he says.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 于是回去请求他，你一定要给我启迪。然后 Gorkishore Das Babaji 说，好吧，让我问问 Krishna, 看他怎么说。
So after some time, then they met again. He said, did you ask Krishna yet? He said, I asked him, but he didn't give me any answer.
过了一段时间之后，他们又见面了，然后他就问说，你有没有问 Krishna? 他说我问了，但是他还没有回复我呢。
So he was stuck. He said, so waited some more time, and then he said, what happened? Did you get an answer yet? And he said, no, I didn't get any. Then he said, my life is useless. I'm going to give up my life. If you're not going to give me initiation, I have no point in living. I'm going to give up the life.
等啊等啊，问说你得到回复了吗？说还没有呢。然后他就说，那你要是不给我启迪的话，我的生命已经没有意义了，我将放弃我的生命。
So then Gorkishore Das Babaji saw that he's very serious. He said, all right, we'll wait for an auspicious day, and that time we can give you initiation.
于是 Gorkishore Das Babaji 看到他非常的有决心，跟他说，那我们等待一个吉祥的日子，在那个时候我就可以启迪你。
So he got his initiation, but then he has to take sannyas. Who should he take sannyas? His spiritual master had already left the world.
他接受了启迪，那他怎么才能够接受 sannyas 呢？因为他的灵性导师已经离开了这个世界。
You have to take sannyas from another sannyasi.
必须要从另外一位 sannyasi 那里接受 sannyas.
Somebody may be a guru, but they cannot give you sannyas unless they're a sannyasi.
有的人可能是一位孤儒，但是除非他自己也是一位萨尼亚西，否则他不能够给你萨尼亚斯。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati had established the temple at the Chaitanya Mat, and he went in behind the altar there, and he went in behind the altar on his own, and it said his spiritual master personally manifested to him and gave him sannyas.
当时Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 已经确立了 Chaitanya Mat 的神庙，于是他独自一人走到了神坛的后面。据说在那个时候，他的灵性导师 Gorkishore Das Babaji 亲自显现在他的面前，赐予了他 sannyas。
So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati established the Gaudiya Vaishnava sannyas.
于是 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 确立了 Gaudiya Vaishnava sannyas.
Previously, we know Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas in the line of Shankaracharya. And the Goswamis, they were all Babajis.
我们知道先前 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他是从 Shankaracharya 的传承接受的 sannyas. 而六 Goswami 们，他们全都是 Babaji。
Babajis, they just wear white cloth and they just beg and they just, you know, they don't usually do a lot of active preaching. They're renounced, but they don't go around traveling different places. They just usually, so the Goswamis, they were like that. They were wearing white and they had their kamandalu and they were in a different tree every night.In the forests of Vrindavan.
Goswami 们他们作为 Babaji 穿白色的衣服，他们不太旅行，不太去做这样的事情，他们非常的气绝，然后在 Vrindavan 每一个晚上住在一棵不同的树下。
But Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati wanted that there should be sannyasis who take on the preaching work, who do the missionary activities and make propaganda for the Vaishnava teachings.
但是 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 他说呢，应该确立 Sannyasi 的这个体系，这样他们可以去做强有力的传播的工作，他们可以去教导大家关于 Vaishnava 的这些体制。
So it was Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati who was a pioneer in this. He took Sannyasi first from his own guru, and then he initiated some of his disciples also as Sannyasis, and he sent them out for preaching.
所以 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 他自己从灵性导师那里接受了 Sannyas 的启迪，然后呢，他也启迪了一些他的门徒，这样呢，派他们去进行传播的工作。
And he even sent some of his initiated disciples and Sannyasis. He sent them to Europe. He sent them to Germany and then to England to preach Lord Chaitanya's message.
他甚至派自己的一些启迪的门徒，一些 Sannyasi 们去欧洲。比如说去德国、去英国去传播主柴坦尼亚的讯息。
And he was supporting them. He would send money to them from India. He would send money to them in Germany and in England so they could maintain themselves.
而且他还维系他们，从印度他给他们寄钱去，让他们在德国、在英国能够生活。
We saw Srila Prabhupada also. Prabhupada was also, he wanted to encourage some devotees. They wanted to go first to.Bangladesh and Nepal. In Prabhupada's time, we did not have any temples or any devotees in Bangladesh or in Nepal. So the devotee went to Prabhupada and he asked Prabhupada about going there. And Prabhupada encouraged him. And Prabhupada also arranged that he could get money every month from Prabhupada's trust to support them in the preaching in Bangladesh and in Nepal.
舍罗帕帕也这样支持他的门徒，在他的那个时代呢，在孟加拉国还有尼泊尔没有庙宇，但是他非常鼓励他的一些门徒去那个地方做传播的工作，而且他确保这些门徒能够每个月从他的信托基金会里得到资金，这样以便维持他们的生活，并且继续传播的工作。
Both Bangladesh and Nepal have quite a large Hindu population, but they're.Quite poor. They're much poorer than India, so it's difficult for the people there. But Prabhupada understood the situation and he wanted to help and encourage the preaching.
在孟加拉国以及尼泊尔有大量的印度教的人口，但是他们的生活非常的贫困，不像在印度这样，他们能够可以支持这种传播的工作。所以说，Prabhupada从他自己这方面。帮助他们，鼓励他们去传播。
In the same way, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, he was preaching here in India. They established, I think, 64 temples around India. But then he also sent his people to Europe, and he sent even people to Burma also for preaching.
而是了 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, 他在印度一共建立了64所 mat, 然后他还派人去欧洲，他甚至还派人去了。缅甸去传播。
So they had the mood to spread the message of Lord Chaitanya.
他们的情感是传播主柴坦尼亚的讯息。
Just like Bhaktivinoda Thakur sent books to the libraries in Canada and in America.
就像是 Bhaktivinoda 他把书籍送到了加拿大还有美国的图书馆。
So these great devotees in our line of the cyclic succession, the acharyas.They were missionaries and they were thinking to spread Krishna consciousness everywhere.
这些我们传承之中的伟大的 Acharya 们，这些伟大的奉献者们，他们都有一种使命，他们的这种传道的使命就是要把 Krishna 的讯息传遍所有的地方。
And in order to spread Krishna consciousness, it was Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati who revolutionized the mode of a sannyasi, because previously sannyasis they would walk everywhere without shoes or with only wooden shoes.
为了这种传道使命，Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 他做出了一些革命性的调整。比如说先前的sannyasi们，他去各个地方传播是不穿鞋子的。
And they would wear clothes without any stitching. So in other words, they just wrap a piece of cloth around them.
而且他们穿的衣服是没有缝过的，这就意味着只是裹一块布在自己的身上。
But it was Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada who introduced sannyasis. He would go in a car. He had a car to go and visit prominent people in the government.
但是 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada 他的安排就是有一辆车，他去拜访那些政府官员的时候就会坐车去。
And when he would go to see them, he would dress with a kirtan and so on, with sewn cloth.
而且他在去拜访他们的时候，他会穿 kutar 这种缝过的衣服。
And he even wore sometimes leather shoes.
他有的时候甚至还会穿皮鞋。
So he would do these things for the sake of meeting these prominent government people.
他这样做的目的就是为了去会见那些政府的显赫的官员。
And because he was meeting these people, he brought some of them even to come out to visit Mayapur.
在遇见这些官员之后呢，他甚至把其中的一些人带到了 Mayapur。
And he was able to establish that the actual birthplace of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not over in Navadvip, but was actually here in Mayapur.
而且他确立了主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的出生地并不在河对岸的 Navadvip, 而是在这里，在 Mayapur.
And Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati also did a lot of pioneering for the Parikrama to discover.Some of the different places of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes.
而且 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 他还做了 Parikrama 的先锋，他发现了很多的主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 逍遥时光的地点。
Have you been to Champahati?
你们去过 Champahati 吗？
去过 Champahati 吗？没过，
去过。
那边有Gorgadharhar 神山 ，Gorgadharhar big.
很大的 Gorgadhar 的神像。
Beautiful Gorga, those deities are, they were the actual deities of a devotee of Lord Chaitanya named Vanina.
那些神像是主 Chaitanya 的一个奉献者，名叫 Vaninath 的，他的神像。
So, they were worshipped there 500 years ago.
500年之前就受到崇拜。
So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati.Somehow they were able to find out these deities where they were. They were not being worshipped. They were not being properly taken care of. And it was Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati who was arranged. He arranged to acquire these deities and then to establish a nice temple for them there at the place of Champahati.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, 他发现了这对神像，然后发现他们没有受到很好的崇拜，受到了忽视。于是他就得到这个神像之后，又在那个Champahati确立了一个地方，好好的崇拜他们。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, he was a very knowledgeable in the scriptures, so much so that on one occasion, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur had been asked to go to a meeting between the Brahmanas because there was some problem about who is actually a Brahman.Because the traditional thinking is that you must be born in a Brahmana family to be a Brahmana. So there was to be a meeting between those who were born in the Brahmana families and those who were not born in Brahmana families but who had taken the sacred thread.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 还非常的熟悉经典上的知识。有一次有人邀请 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 去参加一场辩论会，是因为这是在 Brahmana 之间的一个聚会，有一些人按照传统的观点就认为只有在 Brahmana 家庭之中出生的人才被认为是 Brahmana， 但还是有其他的人没有出生在 Brahmana 的传统的家庭之中，他们的这个地位是怎么样的。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati had to go in place of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was in poor health and he asked Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati to go there. So Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati began his talk, and he began glorifying the Brahmanas, that the Brahmanas are very glorious, that Lord Krishna eats offerings from the Brahmanas, and that the Brahmanas are very dear to Lord Krishna. And all the Brahmanas were thinking, yes, we're very great, you know, we're very good. Everybody was happy that this is good, he's glorifying us.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 代表 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 去参加这个聚会，当时 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 的健康状况不佳。等到了这个聚会之后呢， Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 先开始荣耀 Brahmana， 说 Brahmana 们都是非常伟大荣耀的， Krishna 都从 Brahmana 这里接受供奉的食物，而且呢 Brahmana 们非常受到 Krishna 的真爱，那些 Brahmana 们非常的高兴，他们都扬起脖子觉得、哦、太伟大，是说得太好了。
But then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati turned it around and started explaining who is a real Brahmana and what is the actual qualification of a Brahmana, and that actually Brahmana has nothing to do with birth, but it's to do with activities, quality of work and activities.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 接着转了话题，就是提到到底谁是一个真正的 Brahmana， Brahmana 的品质是什么， Brahmana 的身份其实跟出生没有任何的关系，他应该是具有 Brahmana 的品质，他应该做 Brahmana 的活动。
And he quoted many scriptures, he quoted many different scriptural evidences to support his arguments, and he completely defeated all these caste Brahmanas.
他引用了很多的经典上的证据来证明 Brahmana 是按照他们的活动和品质来被区分和判断的，所以最后他击败了所有那些世袭的 Brahmana 们。
So everyone was greatly impressed with the powerful preaching of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati.
于是每一个人都对 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 强大有力的这种传播，就是对他留下了深刻的印象。
And Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was very fond of printing newspapers and magazines and books all about Krishna consciousness. And he began a daily newspaper. He was publishing a newspaper every day.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 还非常有兴趣于出版关于 Krishna 知觉的、杂志、报纸还有书籍，并且他开始出版一个每一天都在发行的这种新闻的这个、报纸，关于 Krishna 知觉的报纸。
People were shocked that every day a newspaper, but Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati said, look, in Calcutta you have 7 newspapers every day.Daily newspaper, there's 7 papers every day. I'm printing, but that their 7 newspapers are giving the news about Calcutta. My paper is the news of the spiritual world. And the spiritual world is 3/4. The material world is just 1/4. But the spiritual world is 3/4. So I could print a newspaper every second, but there are no customers.
人们非常的惊讶，他居然可以每一天都出一个报纸来讲这个 Krishna 知觉。但是呢，他说在加尔各答你们就有7种不同的报纸，这只不过是这一个地方的报纸，而灵性世界相当于物质世界的3倍，所以我可以每一秒钟都能出一份报纸。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was very fond of publishing books, and our own Bhaktivedanta Swami told us, he saidPublishing magazines and books, this was what I learned from my Guru Maharaj. He said, everything else my father had taught me, worshipping the deity, playing the madanga and harmonium, and singing the songs and the scriptures. But my father didn't know about publishing books. I've learned this from my Guru Maharaj.
我们的 Bhaktivedanta Swami 他说呢，关于出版书籍这一点，他是从 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 那里学习到的。他说我自己的父亲教给了我所有其他的一切，比如说崇拜神像、学习经典、如何的打木当个鼓、如何的打挠钹、做所有其他的这些崇拜。但是关于印书 发行书籍这一点，是他从他自己的灵性导师那里学到的。
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati had the habit to come to his different centers, and he would find out how much money they had.And when he found out how much money they had, then he would think how to spend it for them.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 会去访问他的不同的中心，到了他的不同的中心之后，他就会发现他们到底还有多少钱， 等他发现他们还有多少钱的时候，他就会想办法让他们把钱给花出去。
Yeah, he said, yeah, let's build a diorama exhibition of Lord Chaitanya's pastimes.
他说，比如说我们做一个这种主柴坦的逍遥时光的那些模型。
Or let's have a big festival and make a big pandal and invite all the public and we'll feed everyone prasadam.
或者是说我们举行一个很大的帐篷节日，邀请每一个人来荣耀 prasadam.
Just like sometime in Calcutta in the past, when they celebrate Rath Yatra, they have Rath Yatra for a week, and every night thousands of people come to eat prasadam.
就像在加尔各答以前他们举办弹车节的时候，就会有很大的一个帐篷，每到晚上的时候有一个礼拜的时间，每天晚上都会有成千上万的人来荣耀 prasadam。
And they eat opulent prasadam. It's not just simple khichdi, it's real feast, you know, they have nice preparations. So everybody knows that so many people will all come to eat the prasadam.
而且他们吃的非常的丰盛，并不仅仅是 khichdi 这样的简单的 prasadam， 大家都传开了，所以每个人都来荣耀 prasadam。
And all the big prime, all the big politicians, they also like to come. They like to come and eat.
很大的政治家，他们都喜欢来，他们来参加节目。
So.Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati would come to the temples and he would do things like put on a big festival or arrange artists to make a diorama exhibition. And the devotees would say, oh Guru Maharaj, there'll be no money left. And he would say, yes, good. You will have to go out and sell books and preach.
去了帮 TC 丹的萨尔斯瓦蒂塔库，就这样安排他的门徒把钱都给花了。他们做这个节日，请大家荣耀菩萨的，或者是做这些关于主的逍遥时光的这些模型进行展览。然后他的门徒们就会说 ：“Guru Maharaj， 这样我们就没有钱了。”他说：“好的，这是一件好事儿。这样你们就得再出去卖书，然后传播了。”
He didn't want the devotees just to sit around the temple and.Just eat and sleep and be comfortable.
他并不想让奉献者们变得非常的懒惰，在庙里就是吃睡过得很舒适。
He said the temples are a base for our armies to go out to fight Maya.
他说我们的庙宇就好像是一个基地，是为了让我们的军队出去跟 Maya 作战。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati liked that.Mood to for the devotees to go out in the preaching mood, and if a devotee would go and distribute, and they could only distribute even one newspaper, and collect even just a few paisa, which is a fraction of one rupee, if they collected even just that small amount, he would be very pleased. Very good, you've done very well.
奉献者们出去派书传播 Krishna 知觉，有的时候他们就是卖报纸，这一张报纸只有几 paisa， 相当于卢比的很少的部分，就是几分钱。但即使这样的话， Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 都非常的高兴，说干得好，我非常高兴。
He didn't like devotees just to go to the rich people. He liked them to go to everyone and engage everyone in Krishna's service.
他并不想让他的门徒只去找那些富有的人，他希望让每一个人都能从事于对 Krishna 的服务。
If somebody would come back with a big amount of money, all big bills and everything, you wouldn't say, no, this is not very good. Why are you only going to the rich people?
如果有人回来了，带了钱比较多，都是大票，他就不高兴，说，哦，你为什么总是只找富人？
But if somebody brought, you know, some grains of rice,and some potatoes, and some eggplants, and some money, and different, oh, very good, you're preaching very nicely.
但如果有的人回来的时候就带了一点点钱，然后拿着大米、茄子、土豆，他就说，哦，你干得非常的好，你的传播做得很好。
He liked to see that everyone was being engaged in Krishna's service.
他喜欢看到每一个人都从事于对 Krishna 的服务。
And it said even when he was here in Mayapur, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati would carry some sweets with him. And when the local children, village children would come, he would give them sweets. So all the children would come to him and ask for prasadam.
据说当 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 在 Mayapur 的时候，他总会随身携带一些甜品派发给那些小孩子们吃，所以那些小孩们都会来到他的面前跟他要 prasadam。
So he liked very much to distribute the message of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by chanting the holy name, having nice sankirtan parties.
他非常喜欢通过让大家唱诵圣名，举行很好的 sankirtan 的这个队伍，来传播主 Chaitanya 的讯息。
But he was not so much concerned that the music had to be very melodious and everything had to be perfect. It said that at the time when he left his body, he had the devotee lead the kirtan, and that devotee was someone who he couldn't sing very good.
他并不在乎就是做这个唱诵的时候这个音乐应该有多么的优美，唱得有多好。据说在他离开躯体的时候，他安排奉献者给他做 kirtan， 那个奉献者并不能够唱得很好。
He just wanted, he, but he understood he's a good devotee. He's faithful, very strict follower. So he wanted his mood of pure devotion.
但他知道那个奉献者是一个好奉献者，非常的诚恳，非常的忠诚。他喜欢他这种纯粹奉爱的态度。
So it was Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati who used to say, if you don't chant 64 rounds every day, then you are patita, then you are fallen.
去了 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 常常说，如果每天你不能够唱诵六十四圈的话，你就是 patita， 你就是堕落的。
So in the times of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, that was the standard. At least the devotees staying in the mat in the temple, they were trying all to chant 64 rounds.
在去了 Bhaktisiddhanta 他的那个时代，起码在 mat 里边，在庙里，这个标准是所有的人每一天至少应该唱诵六十四圈。
Of course, sometimes they chant rounds in the morning, japa, and then they do service. At the time they're doing service, they're still chanting.
当然，奉献者们可以早晨的时候 japa 唱诵，接着呢，白天他们做服务，在做服务的时候仍然可以唱诵。
Some people they could finish their rounds early in the morning. Other people they'd finish them during the day when they were doing their service.
有的人可以早晨早早的完成自己的圈数，有的人是白天的时候一边做服务一边完成。
But he didn't like the devotees taking his car to just go to the doctors.
但是他并不喜欢奉献者坐汽车只是为了去看医生。
Said that car is for going for preaching, not for just taking you to the doctor.
他说这个汽车是为了传播用的，不是说仅仅为了带着你去看医生看病用的。
So sometimes devotees have these problems that we want to take the Acharya's car for our own purposes.
有的时候奉献者们就会出现这样的问题，他们拿 Acharya 的车来满足自己的目的。
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, he initiated Srila Prabhupada in 1933. He met him in 1922, and then they met again in 1933. But this time they met in Allahabad.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 是在1933年启迪的我们的 Srila Prabhupada， 他们第一次见面是在1922年，而第二次见面的时候1933年，当时是在 Allahabad。
Allahabad today is called Prayagraj。
Allahabad 如今的名字叫做 Prayagraj。
Raj the king of,
国王、
yeah, Raja means the king, so Prayagraj。So Prayag means the place where the Ganga and the Yamuna and the Saraswati meet. Triveni is there.
Raj 的意思就是国王 Prayag Raj， 这意味着 Yamuna 河、恒河和 Saraswati 河三条河流汇聚在那个地方。
So Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada had come there, and he was having a business there, a pharmacy business.
Bhaktivedanta Swami 当时到了那个地方，他在那儿做生意，他有一个制药的生意。
And then, while he was there, the Gaudiya Math devotees had come to visit him. They'd heard that he's a pious Bengali, and they came to see him. And at that time, they introduced him about the Gaudiya Math.
当时在那里的时候，有 Gaudiya Math 的奉献者们去看他，大家都听说他是一个非常虔诚的孟加拉人，所以。等大家见了他之后，就是介绍他去了 Gaudiya Math。
And then when Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati came there in Allahabad, then Bhaktivedanta Swami came and he got his initiation.
When Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati came to Allahabad, Bhaktivedanta Swami
Prabhupada's name was, before initiation, was Abhay Charan, Abhay Charan Day. And then when he got initiation from Abhay Charan, his name became Abhay Charan Aravinda. Abhay means fearless and Charan feet. So Abhay Charan Aravinda means fearless lotus feet.
Abhay 的意思是无所畏惧，Charan的意思是足， 而 Abhay Charanaravinda 的意思是在莲花足下没有恐惧。And
he received both initiations at the same time.
他是同时接受的两次启迪。Because
he was a lifetime vegetarian, he was educated in Sanskrit, and was born. Of course, we said his father was a Vaishnava. His father was a pure devotee. So Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati recognized that and gave him both initiations at the same time.
Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 认可了所有的这些要点，于是同时给了他两次启迪。
So Srila Prabhupada told us that he only met Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 4 or 5 times.
Srila Prabhupada 告诉我们，他这一辈子只见过Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 4次或者是 5次。
And Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati left the world in 1936. He was initiated in 1933 and he left the world in 1936.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 是在1936年离开躯体的。
So before he left the world, Bhaktivedanta Swami wrote to him and said, you know, I'm a householder. I have not helped you very much in your mission because I've been busy with my family life. Is there any service I can do for you? Can you give me some instruction?
在他的灵性导师隐寂之前, 舍勒帕帕给他的灵性导师写信说我是一个居士。 我希望能够为您做一些服务，您可不可以给我一些训示？
So, at that time, he got a letter from Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati telling him that you're very good in English, so you try to use the English language to preach what you know, and that will be good for you and for those who hear you.
是了，Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 给他写回信说，你的英文很好，所以你应该运用你的英文去给他们传播。 这样不仅对你有好处，对于那些听聆听你的人来讲也有好处。So
because he mentioned about using English, the understanding was that Prabhupada should also take the responsibility to preach in foreign countries.
因为提到了英文，所以这也就暗示着Srila Prabhupada应该接受在外国去传播 Krishna 知觉的责任。So
Prabhupada remembered this final instruction from his guru and took it to his heart. Tried his best to do that.
Srila Prabhupada 接受了他的灵性导师，他的guru给他的这个训示，而且把它牢记在内心之中。后来非常努力的去达成。So
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati left the world in Calcutta at the Gaudiya Math Temple in Bag Bazar, and his body, divine body, was brought out here to Mayapur. After he had departed, they brought his divine body out to Mayapur and put his samadhi up. Just nearby the Chaitanya Mat there.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, 他是在加尔各答的 Bar Bazar 离开躯体的。之后呢，他的躯体被安排运回到 Mayapur， 在这里大家给他做了 Samadhi.
And you can go there and have darshan.
你们可以去那儿 darshan.
Are there any questions?
请问大家有什么问题吗？或者任何的评论？或者任何的评论？请问你有什么补充吗？Radha Charan Prabhu说完美的。
Okay. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Thakur Prabhupada ki. Gaur Bhakti Vrinda. Hare Bol.